I'm Dominic Armato, and this is The Killer Dish.
Arizona knows Mexican food, and the state can boast a wealth of Sonoran cuisine. But at La Marquesa in Phoenix, Cristina Mayon and Felipe Guzman do a killer birria de chivo, one of the iconic dishes of their native Jalisco. Mayon's recipe starts with primal cuts of goat, like the leg or shoulder, which are bathed in a mix of water and vinegar with Mexican spices for 3 days to soften the goat's gamey nature. Mayon removes the goat, pats it dry, rubs it with salt, allows it to rest for 3 more hours, then transfers it to a cazuela, a large clay pot. Mayon rubs the goat with adobo, a smooth blended sauce made with 6 types of chilies, garlic, and vinegar, then covers the meat with sliced tomatoes, oranges, onions, and even more spices before filling the cazuela partway with a seasoned tomato puree. She then takes huge agave leaves that have been roasted in the oven, cuts them to size, and places them over the goat, closing the cazuela and sealing the lid with handfuls of masa. The goat goes back into the refrigerator to marinate for 3 more days. Then the cazuela is transferred to the oven where the goat roasts overnight. When Mayon breaks off the masa seal and removes the lid, tender steaming meat emerges. But she isn't done yet. She pulls the meat, bastes it with a little more adobo, then returns it to the hot oven to take on a light char before it's doused with the braising liquid and served with tortillas, limes, and cilantro and onion for garnish. The birria is magnificent, a complex, deeply layered dish with a pronounced sourness and an intense aroma led by a heady blast of chilies, clove, and garlic. The meat has heft and texture, but it's soft, and as the fibers separate, they wick up the flavorful consommé. There are so many flavors going on, it's difficult to keep track, but they balance perfectly and drift into the background as the meat steps to the fore. It's a special dish that's both brash and comforting, a little wild on the palate, but easy to sink into.
There's a lot of people that knows how to do it. There's a lot of people that doesn't know, that they prefer just to go to a restaurant. Mm-hmm. So it's something that takes a lot of time and a lot of process. So there's a lot of people that doesn't know how to do it.
Right.
So they prefer just to go to a restaurant.
What to you makes a good birria? What makes, you know, when you have, when you say there's a good, what, yeah, what makes a good birria?
The good birria is the consomme. Also the tatemado, you see how it looks like darker, the edge. That means that is tatemado, that is toasted with the sauce and or the adobo, let's say.
Right. As opposed to, like, because I know a lot of places you get birria around town, it's sort of the big bowl, the shredded meat, the big
exactly.
bowl of consomme. But yeah. This is different.
Yeah, this is more like the traditional style.
I mean, it's a really gorgeous dish, and to have it done like this, it's not something you see in a whole lot of places in this town. So it's really, really special. Thank you so much, Christine. I really appreciate it.
Thank you for coming.
Thank you.
I'm Dominic Armato, and I'll see you soon for the next Killer Dish.